Hello everyone, Kevin with Leading Edge Equipment. Today I would like to walk you through the Machine Sync feature running on the Gen 4 display platform. We have several machines out here in the field. We're going to be running an X9 with an 8RX and also an S780. But before we get started, there's a few components that we need to make sure that we have on these machines. There's a chart listed here that if you pause for a few seconds, you can read through that to make sure you have these before we're operating in the field. Now what we're gonna do is jump into each one of these machines and complete the setup, and we'll walk you step by step on how to do that, and then we're gonna operate these machines in the field. Okay, now that we're up in the cab on one of these combines, I'm gonna show you how to set this one up before we can connect the grain cart tractor to each one of our combines that we have in the field. So for starters, I had mentioned there on that chart, one of the steps that we gotta make sure we have is the activation. Let's go into the menu, the system, software manager, activations, and then making sure that green light is next to Machine Sync. If you see a blue light, that means it's demo. If you see a gray light, that means it's inactive. So we need to get a hold of either us or your local dealer to be able to unlock that. Taking a step back, in the same systems page, we need to make sure we go to the wireless settings here. What we are gonna set up in here is the mobile to machine. That's gonna be the grain cart tractor connecting to us. So each one of the combines, if you're running more, is gonna need to set this up with your own personal name and password for the grain cart tractor to connect to. We do this by hitting that pencil next to the mobile to machine. You can put any name on the network that you want. I suggest something easy for you to be able to identify for the grain cart tractor. So in this scenario, we have one X9 and one S780. So that's what we're gonna name them as the model of the combine, so it's easy for the grain cart tractor to connect and identify. The other thing is the network password. When you're setting that up, it has to be at least 8 characters. I suggest using something easy and the same as what you use in the other combine. That way they don't get mixed up. Once that's set up, verify that your mobile to machine is on. That's the only way that the grain cart tractor is going to connect to you. So make sure that's there. Taking a step back out to the home page, I suggest best practice is making a hotkey on the bottom of your shortcut bar for both the sharing and the sync, making sure that all the machines are connected here with the blue arrows. And then the sync, so if you touch it, it brings up all the machine sync capabilities there. I suggest that because most of the time you're probably gonna be running other things like the combine settings and adjustments. And this makes it easy when you're in that operation for machine sync. You can just touch that and then see all the operations there. Make sure that our machine sync's on. All your information will be listed here. And then when we get into the operation mode, I'll show you what a lot of the other things mean as far as the status and the nudging and setting the home points. Okay, now that we're in the tractor, we're gonna need to go through the same setup that we did in the combine to be able to connect to that machine. For starters, just like the one before, we need to make sure we have the appropriate activation unlocked. To do that, it was the menu on the bottom right, system, the third one down on the left, and then software manager. The activations, we're looking for that machine sync to be unlocked in green. Once we've verified that, we're good to go on the activation bundle. We're gonna take a step back out of here, but not all the way back to the home screen. We're gonna go to that wireless settings. From here, we need to do the machine to wireless. What we had set up in the combine is what we're looking to connect to, so we need to turn that on. Once that's on, we go to the pencil. Then we can search by touching that white box there on the available ones. The X9 here is what we're looking to do. And then type your appropriate password that we assigned earlier in there so we can connect to that machine. This will need to be done if you're running multiple combines, so make sure you have all that information ready when you jump into the grain cart tractor. Taking a step back out of here, best practice, just like in the combine, I suggested having these hotkeys down on the bottom. When running through the field in the grain cart tractor, you might only have the one display with the ISOBUS compatible scale, so you're gonna be navigating between multiple pages. I recommend it's easiest to have this sync icon at the bottom along with your sharing. That way you can simply just touch on it. It brings you to the full operational machine sync page there. We'll go ahead and kick that on to make sure that everything is appropriately working. And then from here, you can look at your available networks and connect to the appropriate machine. When these machines are running in the field, you'll get a percentage of your bin level for each one. And you can even set up one of the pages to be able to show you the percentages of each of the machines in there, so you know which one is ready to be dumped. So now we can go on to the actual operation in the field, so you can see this actually running and connecting to each of the machines. So now that we're in the field and operating, before we get started on the unloading process, the first thing that has to be accomplished is setting our home point. What that is going to do is allow us to have this orange box around our grain cart, and then it'll set a home point to where every time we come back in again on the next pass, it's going to line up on that point specifically. So once we're where we want to be, we can hit the set home point, and then from there, in the combine, the operator has the ability to nudge left and right and forward and backwards depending on what your increments are. So now operating in the field for the machine sync process, here we're actually driving the tractor up for the unloading process here. As we come in, we're going to try to get to our home point as quick as we can, but then we're going to match the speed of the combine. If the combine is already auto tracking, we're on a safe straight line. When the tractor comes in, we're going to hit the resume auto steer button, and that'll take over to where the combine is able to control what the tractor is doing, and then the combine has the ability to nudge forward, backwards, and left and right like we had talked about before. If you guys have any other questions on the machine sync feature itself, make sure you get a hold of us here at Leading Edge Equipment, and as always, we appreciate your business.